What you doing?
I'm splitting some acacia wood for spoon making. Softwood or black. Split the first spoon black. Right there. Nice. Nice dark wood. The inner core wood, which should oxidize to a nice black color. Side would be the handle. So I'm just cleaning the central face because the rest on the sides is wastage. Got the soft core. That's a smooth face. Sapwood off the outside. back of the spoon and the front of the spoon. And the back. Nice flat face. I'm trying to get the back even. That's a good rough shape for the base of the spoon. A flat front and a basic profile across the back extends to about where my fingers are, and the rest is handle. So we avoid this old knot hole and that one. Now it's time to do the spoon design. We have our rough idea of what we want. We just knock the corners off either side of the pattern, leaving a little bit of wood either side. The more wood you take off with the adz, the less knife work there is, which means it's more time effective to use the adz for rough work like that.
cool.
Now we need to do this side, which is not so easy. Maintained good symmetry on both sides of the spoon, and now the basic outline is there. The handle needs to be worked down quite a lot, but the grain seems to spread as it goes further back, which is interesting. This will be incorporated in the handle. Good. Cut it off here with a saw. Just behind the knot, where the grain goes from there. The roughing of the spoon is more or less done. We're cut short by a rainstorm, so I think we shall retreat indoors or to our veranda and continue with knife the rest of the spoon. Thank you. see what's happening on the front. Spoon is shaped now with a knife, as you can see, not that much more required, just smoothing out the edges, and it will now go to sanding for final finishing.
Cool.
There you go. Now there's a lot of sanding to get all the high points off and remove all the marks from the carving. All of these need to be removed to get a smooth finish.
Wow! You end up in stuck in the tent.
After sanding, give it a light olive oil, covering of olive oil, and then we let it stand for a bit in the shade, and then you wipe off the excess so it's not sticky, and spoon is ready for use.
Voila.
I'm doing.